I'm Mark Daniel. I'm a professor of epidemiology at the University of Canberra. I lead the development of the Australian Geospatial Health Lab. Work being done in this area of science was pretty much limited to understanding census type information in relation to the health of people living in those census areas. What wasn't being addressed was the actual context, the built environment, things that are on the ground, food outlets, roadways, transportation networks.
The aim of the GeoHealth Lab is to foster research collaboration across research, academics, local government, state government, anyone really who's interested in understanding how health and place interact.
Working on a project of this size means that it was unfeasible to use a manual process, and therefore we had to look at a way of automating this. We can then take this data and visualize it and use this to communicate findings with government, community, and other research organizations.
One of the objectives for many of us in research, especially in public health, is that we want to actually shape policy to improve the health for populations. So the more quality research that we can do using similar variables between states, between countries, it gives us a stronger evidence base that can be used to then leverage policy change.
The Geospatial Health Lab brings all of the data together using ArcGIS Portal, ArcGIS Server, and the other components of ArcGIS Enterprise, and allows academics to access this information in a single ubiquitous fashion.
A good example of community benefit is work in Adelaide, where we showed the characteristics of local urban environments related to the development of cardiometabolic risk over 10 years in 4,000 people in a population-based cohort. It extends from that to showing that the environment shaped the impact of an obesity prevention and lifestyle program. That was a $45 million federal, state, and local initiative in South Australia. And it extends to the Northern Territory, where we're showing that infrastructure for remote communities is related to infectious disease and chronic disease outcomes.
An example of how geospatial has been used in health research is cardiac ARIA. It's an accessibility model that looks at how the population can access acute or emergency cardiac facilities and post-cardiac facilities on discharge from hospital. The fundamental was to see whether or not people would have that 1 hour access to some form of cardiac service. What we were able to show is that there were many parts of remote and rural Australia that had much poorer access to services and less service delivery.
The real power of the Geospatial Health Lab is that researchers and scientists, academics, can get access to all of the indicators they need to do analysis in health studies in the one location.
GIS, in my opinion, is an all-pervasive enabler. So if all disciplines can benefit, all data is spatial, the thing you need is the tool that links those. The tool is GIS.